This is Russ Andersson with another tracking example. Here's our shot. We're going by a warehouse here, and we're simply going to track it. Maybe we're going to do something to the warehouse or whatever. So we're going to start out just by running the auto tracker on this example shot. So we might be adding something here. We might add something on top of the building. But you can look and see that there are a couple of issues here that we're going to have to address. One is that there are a lot of repeated patterns here along the fence, along this little row of pylons and so on. And those things are typical trouble spots. So what we're going to do is just jump over to the tracker graphs and do a Control A to select all the trackers. I'm just going to turn off the positions display. And this will immediately jump out to you that there are two trackers here that have these rather large spikes. And here's one of them. It just jumps along that repeated pattern here. So we'll just take it out. And similarly, here's another one that we'll take a look at. And that's these little repeated traffic cones or whatever. And there's a jump in that later. So again, we'll just delete those two. Now, we can go at this point and do a solve, and let's take a look at what happens. Now, you'll notice there's message comes up that says, warning, not a crisp solution, using a safer algorithm. And that happens when there are kind of marginal numeric issues going on in the algorithm based on the tracking data that it sees. It switches back to a slower and safer algorithm, which will let it proceed, but it's an indicator that something's going on that we need to take a look at. In this particular shot, what that is are these trackers that are way off in the distance there that don't really contribute very much in the way of information, and in fact can throw off the solution. So here we have our initial solution, and you'll see a couple of funny things. Here are these points way off in the distance. You'll see they're back here at the base of that bridge, and everything else is really all compressed down by the camera. See, there's some that are closer. I keep zooming in here. Now you see even that there are a couple behind the camera. And if you look, those are actually out in that distance also. And the problem is that when you have those things, there's very little perspective, and even the slightest amount of noise corresponds to a tremendously large change in the distance to them. So they can wind up far away, they can wind up behind the camera, and so on. And, you know, the easiest way to address them is with our handy-dandy delete key. And you can just wipe those out. And we can do the same thing with these others. And at this point, maybe what we'll do is just go and select them here. I'm just using the control key as I do this lasso so that I select the 3D points as well as the visible trackers. Still, I got a couple more over here. I could make them far alternatively, but that's really doesn't add very much to anything in general. It kind of makes things a little more confusing to handle later on. So we have plenty of trackers, so we'll just delete those. And now when we go and do the solve again, and we're doing it again from scratch just to show, see there are no messages, and also it's going through faster as well. And now we're done. So that's just a quick look at some cleanups on the trackers. It's always worthwhile to take a look at those trackers before you go and do a solve. Look for ones that are have little jumps in them, like those repeated texture ones that are really far away, ones that are things on actual moving objects. Thanks. Hope that helps you out.